So in biology today we are going to proceed, and today we are going to look at the process of excretion in the kidney. So the process of excretion in the kidney involves ultrafiltration, which is also referred to as pressure filtration. It also involves selective reabsorption, and it also involves osmoregulation. So each glomerulus is supplied by blood by the afferent vessel. So the afferent vessel are wider than the efferent vessel that takes away blood from the glomerulus. And due to this, pressure is created. And when pressure is created, some small substances that are able to pass through the glomerulus, they pass through the walls of the glomerulus into the Bowman's capsule. And these substances, they include salts, water, glucose, and urea. And substances that are large, that are found in the blood, they don't pass through the glomerulus. And this includes the proteins such as the fibrinogens. Also the blood cells, they don't pass through the glomerulus. So the substances that pass through the glomerulus, they are referred to as the glomerular filtrate. And that process is actually referred to as ultrafiltration or pressure filtration. And some of these substances, they are still needed by the body. So they are going to travel down, and when they reach the renal tubule, that's where selective reabsorption takes place. So selective reabsorption is where the body selects the substances that it still needs. So some substances such as salts, the water molecules, and glucose, they are reabsorbed back into the bloodstream. And when reabsorption takes place, the substance that remains is referred to as urine. So urine actually includes, we have urea, water, and salts. And this urine will go through the collecting duct, and after it goes through the collecting duct, it will go out of the kidney through the ureter. And after it goes out of the ureter, it will pass through the ureter and it will collect in a muscular bag, which is referred to as the bladder. So before you passing out urine from the body, urine is actually controlled by the sphincter muscles. So if you want to go to the toilet, you actually control the sphincter muscles to open up and you can go to the toilet. But the sphincter muscles, they are not found in babies. That's why when the bladder for the babies is full, the urine automatically comes out. So I've actually explained the two processes. Ultrafiltration, which is also referred to as pressure filtration, I've also explained selective reabsorption. Let's now look at osmoregulation. So how does osmoregulation take place? So osmoregulation is referred to as the regulating of water molecules in the body. So what happens if you have high water levels in the body, or what happens if you have low levels of water in the body? So if you have high water levels in the body, these are the processes that happens. So as blood passes through the brain, the hypothalamus contains the osmoreceptors. And these osmoreceptors, they're going to detect the amount of water molecules in blood. And if it is found that you have high levels of water in the blood, the hypothalamus won't make the pituitary gland to secrete ADH. And the absence of ADH in the blood will cause the nephron not to be more permeable to water. So what do I mean? So during the process of selective reabsorption, I said that some water molecules are reabsorbed back into the bloodstream. So if you have higher levels of water, less of water molecules are going to be reabsorbed. And this means you are going to the urine that is going to be produced, it will be dilute and in high volume. So you are going to pass out large volume of urine. So that's how the body controls high levels of water. Let us now look at how the body controls low levels of water. So the processes that occur are these processes. So as blood passes through the brain, the hypothalamus contains the osmoreceptors. So these osmoreceptors, they are going to detect the amount of water in blood. And if it is found that you have low levels of water in blood, the hypothalamus will make the pituitary gland to produce the hormone, which is referred to as the antidiuretic hormone. And the antidiuretic hormone is going to diffuse into the bloodstream and to be transported to the nephron. So when it reaches the nephron, it's going to cause the nephron to be more permeable to water. So this means that during the process of selective reabsorption, much of the water molecules are going to be reabsorbed so that you can maintain the water levels in blood. And when high levels of water are reabsorbed, this means that the urine that you're going to produce is going to be concentrated and in less volume. So these are the processes that you need to take into consideration. So I'm going to draw the structure of the nephron. So the structure of the nephron looks in this way. So you have the glomerulus. So this is the structure of the nephron. Then this part is referred to as the glomerulus. Then we have this part, which is the branch from the rhino artery. Then this cup-shaped thing is referred to as the Bowman's capsule. Then the cold part here is the rhino tuber. Then the U-shaped structure is referred to as the loop of Henle. Then you have the collecting duct. Then we also have a branch from another nephron. Then this is the branch from the rhino vein. Then this is the blood capillary. So I said that the glomerulus is supplied by blood, which is the afferent vessel. So this is the afferent vessel. So this is wider than the efferent vessel. And due to this, pressure is created here, and some small particles that are able to diffuse from the glomerulus, they enter the Bowman's capsule, and these include salts, water, urea, and glucose. So these substances are referred to as the glomerular filtrates, and the process that happens here is referred to as ultrafiltration or pressure filtration. So there are some substances that are not able to pass through the glomerulus, and these include the red blood cells and the fibrinogen. So these will be transported by the blood capillary. But the glomerular filtrate will be collected in the Bowman's capsule, and it will go down, it will reach the rhino tuber. And this glomerular filtrate, there are some substances that